talking struggle of my people. Oh yes, I'm a common kuma. Jekobara, Thomas Sankara. I've been Baptist to Mumba. I've been Captain Aster. I've been Sheikh Ture. I've been Marcus Gabe. I've been Kwame Ture. I've been Shaka Zulu. I've been Fela Kuti. I've been Isaac Goro. I've been Beko Kuti. I've been the silence of the enemy. The lost presence of history.
You're probably overusing your backbeats. Now, what is a backbeat? Backbeats when you're hitting the two and the four. Doom, doom, ta, a doom, doom, ta, a doom, doom, ta, 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 doom, ta, right? A good audience will be clapping on the two and the four. And it's usually the first things we do when we drum. I know, like, we live in a backbeat world. We hear them all the time. You probably heard them in your mother's womb. And I know, like, when I first started picking up the sticks and going for it, like, it was the first thing that I did, just doom ta, doom ta, doom doom ta, and playing the backbeats. But sometimes we don't look at history from zooming out. So backbeats only were really invented around the 50s, like the mid 50s. And a lot of people say it was Rock Around the Clock. That was like one of the first times a backbeat was heard. And it just blew up in popularity and really started getting into the modern culture. And nowadays we just take for granted because it's like everywhere, right? And we hear it. But I hear from a lot of drummers, and I know I went through this myself, where you're like, I'm playing the same old, and sometimes when you just play, you're like, dum-ga, dum-ga, okay, what now? I'm going into jazz is a good way to start breaking out of backbeats. And you may have already done that. And I like to say all roads lead to jazz. So that's a really cool way to look at drumming. You get that swing pulse in your playing, and that's really the root of the instrument. But one of my favorite things to just get out of the backbeat thinking is going into Afrobeat and playing along to Fela Kuti and the Kuti family, Sean Kuti and Fela Kuti. And Fela Kuti is one of the originators of this sound called Afrobeat, so it's like African rhythms with like funk grooves, very syncopated, and it's almost like actually zero backbeats. And there's an excellent drummer, Tony Allen. If you don't know Tony Allen, check him out. And a lot of this stuff I'll just put on regularly just to get out of my backbeat thinking. And I know like Stewart Copeland from The Police, he was really into this because with the Police, he was like, I don't want to play a backbeat all the time. I want to think differently. Carter Beauford from Dave Matthews Band, one of my biggest inspirations, also was like, why do I always have to play a backbeat? Let me get out of it. So jam with some Afrobeat and just any way you can get out of that backbeat sometimes box that we get stuck in, and challenge yourself to go to your edges and become the drummer you were meant to be.
I be the pain of the revolutionary. I be the memory of the fallen warrior. I be the walking, talking struggle of my people. Oh yes, I become a kuma. I be Jekobara. Sankara, I've been Baptist to Mumba, I've been Captain Aster, I've been Sheikh Ture, I've been Marcus Gabe, I've been Kwame Ture, I've been Shaka Zulu, I've been Fela Kuti, I've been Isaac Goro, I've been Beko Kuti, I've been the silence of the enemy, the lost presence of history, I've been the root of the family, the noise of a victory, oh, they don't know. Oh, they don't know.